Hello, my name is Molly Urban, and I wanted to share another perspective on leadership today. We've been talking about how to navigate our teams through these very challenging economic, political, and social times. I hear almost daily how people are so overwhelmed and leaders don't know what to do to help. One of the ways we can help not make the situations worse and ensure we keep ourselves healthy is to take a step back before responding to these challenging issues and apply contrastive thinking on ourselves. Contrastive thinking is actively looking to prove yourself wrong. So why would I try to prove myself wrong? It may feel counterintuitive because it actually is. Our brains naturally work from a comparative perspective. We take in information and the comfort force within us tries to make it agree. We're seeing a lot of negative political discourse right now as we get closer to the elections. Much of the contention is rooted in comparative thinking, and it has been proven to damage your brain. Around the time of the 2004 presidential elections, a study was done with partisan Democrats and partisan Republicans. Each person was shown a set of contradictory statements by the candidates. The participants' brains were scanned with an fMRI, and the results were very telling. When people watched the contradictory statements by the opposition's candidates, their brains worked correctly. The part of the brain that detects contradictions was active. However, a completely different pattern was observed when the participants watched contradictory statements by their candidates. The same part of the brain was not active, and the area of the brain that reinforces reward was active. Essentially, the brain was now wired to avoid detecting the contradiction and convinced itself that it had looked for one. Think about this for a minute. The person believes they have checked for a contradiction in their candidate. Not only don't they think they saw one, they also felt good about checking for the contradiction. This is an unhealthy brain. I don't want this for my home team. When we are contrastive on ourselves, we consider how our approach, idea, or perspective could be wrong. Not that it is, but how could it be wrong? If there are flaws, you will catch them before anyone else points it out. You self-correct before it affects anyone else, and you maintain a healthy brain. When tempers begin to flare with my home team, I immediately start to look for comparative thinking and start to ask questions to help them consider another perspective. So, are you ready to dissolve all your team's issues by helping each of them focus on proving themselves wrong first? Thank you for letting me share my leadership thought. Have a great week.